Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 9.2. We are going to discuss the design of multi-speed gearbox using the PSG design data book. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the procedure for the design of speed reducer or constant mesh gearbox. So the learning outcome to the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to design multi-speed gearbox using the PSG design data book. So gearbox design, there are two types of gearbox, constant mesh gearbox or speed reducer, which we have discussed in the earlier lecture, and sliding mesh gearbox or multi-speed gearbox, which is popularly used in the automobile gearbox and the machine tool gearbox. The design procedure for gearbox, multi-speed gearbox, we will discuss in this lecture. And this is the gearbox of a motorcycle. So by pressing the pedal, we can change the gear to get different output speed. So it is a multi-speed foot pedal gearbox, gear control, shift cam assembly for the gearbox, automobile, motorcycle. And this is again a sliding mesh gearbox of an automobile. So by shifting the lever, we can get different output speed. And we find number of gears for different stages of the gear shifting. And this is the gearbox, multi-speed gearbox of a gas turbine generator unit. The shaft connecting the gas turbine and the electrical alternator or generator. This is again another gearbox, multi-speed gearbox used in the generator and turbine unit. And this is the layout of a gearbox. So the from the engine to the differential, it is used for the automobile gearbox. And this is again another gearbox, layout of the gears for multi-speed gearbox arrangement. And this is again a line diagram of the sliding mesh gearbox. So the gear which is sliding, it is on the shaft. So by shifting gear and engaging with the gear, various gears, so we will get the different output speeds. And this is the four output speed and the reverse gear arrangement, the meshing of speed, first gear, second gear and reverse gear and getting the output speed. And this is the animation of shifting the gear and getting different output speed to the wheel. Ratio, reduction ratio, gain reduction, and this is 1:1. So engine speed is equal to the wheel speed. And the design of multi-speed gearbox using the PSG design data book. So this is we will discuss the procedure. The information required for the design of gearbox: the highest output speed required, the lowest output speed, number of steps into which the range between maximum speed and minimum speed is divided, the number of stages in which the number of speed is achieved. Number of stages means 2x2, 3x2, like that. So we will discuss later number of stages. So these are all the input required for designing a gearbox. So basically highest speed, lowest speed and number of steps. These are all the basic information for designing a gearbox. And the first step, we have to calculate the progression ratio. So progression ratio is defined by to maximum speed by minimum speed to the power 1/z-1, where z is the number of steps. For example, z may be 9 speed gearbox, for 6 speed gearbox, z equal to 12 speed gearbox, or 18 for 18 speed gearbox. And once we calculate phi value, then we have to take the standard value from R40 series. The preferred numbers we have used in the fifth semester itself for design of the shaft. So R5 series, R10 series, R20 series, R40 series. In this design, we have to select the progression ratio from R40 series. So this is part of the R40 series table, and we have to continue. So we have to read 1.06, 1.12, and then it will go to 10. Then suppose the progression ratio is higher, then we have to repeat 10.6, 11.2, 11.8, 12.5, 13.2, 14.0, 15.0, 16.0, like that. Then finally it will be 100. When further if it is increasing, then we have to read 100, 106, 112, 118. So that is how we have to repeat the number in the series number, R40 series. Normally we take the number of teeth on the gear as well as the progression ratio from the R40 series for the gearbox design. So the reading, how to use the chart, how to use the table for selecting the number, right? I will discuss the detailed use of the R40 number in the solving problem. Then we have to fix the number of stages for transmission U. The maximum number of stages should be 4 to have optimum size of the gearbox. When the number of stages are increasing, the overall size of the gearbox will increase. So maximum number of stages are 4 maximum. So single stage, double stage, 3 stage or 4 stages. And we have to draw the structural diagram. So first diagram that you have to draw, there are 3 different diagrams you have to draw in the gearbox design. Based on the, because you have to complete everything in 30 minutes for an examination point of view, some of the diagram we will simplify, and some problem, some example problem will be using only the ray diagram, not the structural diagram. So if you are familiar with the structural diagram, then it is very easy to draw the other arrangement, for example ray diagram or the kinematic arrangement for the gearbox design. The structural diagram gives the information about the number of shaft in the gearbox, number of gear in each shaft, the order of changing transmission in individual group to get the desired spindle speed, the transmission range and characteristics in each group. So these are all the information available in the structural diagram. And to draw the structural diagram, first structural formula is to be selected. So you have to select the formula. The following table you can refer for structural formula. Suppose we can use the single stage. Three steps, three different output speed, we can use the single stage. Suppose you have four steps, then we have to use the two stage. The two stages may be 2x2, and if you have 6 speed, you have to use 3x2 or 2x3. And when you have eight output speed, then we can use the two stages, 4x2. So 4 gears in the first shaft, 2 gears in the second shaft. Then we have 3 stages also. We can use for 8, we can use 3 stages, 2x2x2. That means 2 gear in each shaft. For 9 speed gearbox, we can use the 2 stages. So 3x3. So 3 gears in each shaft. Then 12 speed gearbox, we have different structural formula, different combination is possible. Necessarily we have to use the 3 stages, 3 stage gearbox. So 2x3x2, 2x2x3, 3x2x2. So the first number in the first number indicates number of gears in the first shaft, number of gears in the second shaft, number of gears in the third shaft, like that. So for 16 speed, you may have 2x4x2, 2x2x4, 4x2x2. For 18 speed, 3x3x2, 3x2x3, 2x3x3. For 24 speed, 3x4x2, 3x2x4, 3x2x3x4, 2x4x3, 4x3x2, 4x2x3. And 32 speed, 4x4x2, 2x4x4, 4x2x4. So these are all the different structural formula possible for 3 stages of multiple speed. Normally in the examination point of view, we may be design speed gearbox, 9 speed gearbox, 12 speed gearbox and the 18 speed gearbox in our design problem solving. And for plotting the structural diagram, The following steps you have to follow. The following steps may be followed. First, draw U+1 vertical lines at convenient distance from each other. So, U is the number of steps. Suppose you have 2 steps, you have to draw 3 vertical lines at the convenient distance. Then draw an array of horizontal lines intersecting the vertical lines at a distance of log phi from each other. So, phi is the progression ratio. So, log phi you have to take, you have to draw number of horizontal lines at a gap of log phi. The number of horizontal lines equal to number of steps of gearbox. Suppose you have 8 speed gearbox, you have to draw 8 horizontal lines. 9 speed gearbox, you have to draw 9 horizontal lines. Different structural diagrams are possible for a particular number of stages. Say for example, for a 3 stage gearbox, the number of structural diagram possible are 3 factorial, that is 6. So, the optimum structural diagram is selected keeping the following information in mind. So, there are different combinations as we shown, discussed in the previous table, there are different combinations possible and we have to select the optimum structural diagram by considering the following parameter. So, number of gears in the last shaft should be minimum. Last shaft means the third stage. Suppose the three stage gearbox, third stage number of gears should be minimum. Number of gears on one shaft should not generally more than 3, but in some exceptional cases it may be 4, not more than 4, because when you have more number of gears, the bending, the force on the particular shaft will increase, then the shaft design will be complicated or we will get a bigger shaft for carrying the load. And the structural diagram, examples of the structural diagram, and this is the structural diagram for 2x3 arrangement. So, the driving shaft, first shaft, driven shaft. We have 6 different speeds, N1, N2, N3, N4, N5, N6. So, we have to select N1 to N6 from the R40 series. N6 is the maximum speed, N1 is the minimum speed, and this is how the speed is changing. So, for the driven shaft, driving shaft to the first shaft, there are 2 speeds. By engaging appropriate gears, we will get 2 output speeds for the shaft 1. Then from shaft 1 to driven shaft, you will get for every speed, you will get 3 different speeds. So, by changing the gear, we can get 6 different output speed in the driven shaft. And this is the structural diagram for 2x3x2. So, for the, there are 3 stages, driving shaft, shaft 1, shaft 2, shaft 3. 3 are the driven shaft, first stage, second stage and third stage, and we have 12 steps. There are 12 speed gearbox. So, for first, between the first shaft and the driving shaft and the first shaft, you have 2 output speed. From the shaft 1 to shaft 2, for every speed, you have 3 different speeds. From shaft 2 to driven shaft, for every speed, you will get the 2 different speeds. So, this is how we are getting 12 output speeds on the driven shaft. And this is structural diagram for 2x3x3. This is again 12 different speeds. So, first, between the first shaft and the second shaft, 2 speeds. Between the second shaft and third shaft, 2 speeds. And between the third shaft and the driven shaft, it is again 3 speeds. This is again 12 speed gearbox. Then again, 4x3, again 12 speed gearbox. So, for first shaft and the second shaft, you have 2 stages here. So, between the first shaft and the second shaft, we have 4 different speeds and between the second shaft and the driven shaft, we have 3 different speeds. And this is the structural diagram for 9 speed gearbox 3x3. Now, for 9 speed gearbox, we have only one option. So, we have to necessarily take this structural diagram. For 12 speed gearbox, I have shown 3 different diagrams. Among the 3, you can select the best one, optimum one. So, we may select all the 3, suppose if we solve 3 problems, we will take all the 3 diagrams and we will design the gear. And next we have to draw the speed chart. This is also called as ray diagram. So, once you draw the structural diagram correctly, then the speed chart is very easy. Then the speed chart gives information about the transmission ratio of all transmission and the speed value of each gearbox shaft. So, the earlier diagram, speed diagram, it just gives the distribution of the gear arrangement, distribution of the shaft. Now, here the transmission ratio for each engagement is calculated by the speed chart or the ray diagram. So the line joining point of adjacent shaft indicates the transmission ratio. So in the earlier diagram, we have shown a line connecting the first shaft and the second shaft. So in the speed chart, we have to indicate the I value in the line. If the line is horizontal, I equal to 1. There is no change in the speed. If the line is inclined upward, I is greater than 1. That is, speed is increasing. If the line is inclined downward, I is less than 1. That is, speed is decreasing. That is what the meaning for horizontal line. Line inclined upward, line inclined downward. Then the restriction for the transmission ratio. The I maximum less than or equal to 2. When the speed increases, it should be less than or equal to 2. I minimum, if it is speed reduces, it should be 0.25 or 1/4. So 2 and 1/4, they are the limitations. Suppose if you have a higher value on either side, the number of teeth on a particular gear will be more, so that you will increase the diameter of the PCD, pitch circle diameter of the gear, that again will increase the overall size of the gearbox. So we have to restrict I maximum to I minimum 1/4 or 0.25. Then minimum speed reduction limited for 4 to keep the radial dimension of the gearbox within the limit. So the radial dimension? So the size of the gear will increase. When the size of gear is increasing, then overall size of the gearbox will increase. The maximum increase in the speed is limited to 2 times due to the limitation of pitch line velocity. Then following steps may be followed, the speed chart or the ray diagram. Draw vertical lines, one greater than the structural diagram. Suppose you have 3-stage diagram, you have 3 lines, then you have to draw 4 lines in the speed chart. Number of lines, vertical lines equal to 1 greater than the structural diagram. Draw the horizontal line intersecting the vertical lines at convenient distance. So there is no limitation now. Now you have to draw line horizontally. So for that you can, nowadays the answer paper itself, it is a ruled sheet. You can conveniently use the ruled sheet for drawing the horizontal line. Then from R40 series, take the minimum speed N1 closest to the value given in the problem. So sometimes the same number may be available, or the closest number we have to take from the R40 series. Then you have to take the N1, N2, N3 up to NZ value from R40 series for the calculated progression ratio. So this area you have to understand how to select the speed from between the maximum speed and the minimum speed from R40 series using the progression ratio. So this I will clarify when solving the problem. Then draw the number of horizontal lines is determined by the following manner. Now we have motor speed. Motor speed also we have to include in the ray diagram. If NZ is the maximum speed is less than the motor speed, where draw Z number of horizontal lines. NM is the motor speed. If NZ is greater than NM, then draw as many additional lines so that NM can be located within the speed chart. Draw the ray representing the transmission between the last shaft and the shaft preceding. You have to start from the last shaft and you have to go backward. Then rays may be drawn for other transmission. So last shaft to the preceding shaft and then the previous shaft. So you have to reach to the first stage of the gearbox. Then speed of the motor does not coincide with the standard spindle speed. Therefore, motor speed is to be reduced to standard spindle speed in the next succeeding shaft by selecting appropriate transmission ratio. That we will see in the problem solving. Then you have to draw the kinematic arrangement. So the third drawing is the kinematic arrangement. So this is the kinematic arrangement where you can see 2 by 3 by 2. So the motor shaft, it is a driving shaft, this is the driven shaft. So there are 2 changes in the speed, and here you can have 3 different speeds and you will get the 2 different speeds for engagement. By shifting the gear, we can get different output speed, 12 speeds in the driven shaft. Then select suitable material for the gear. So the, up to this, it is new. Up to this, it is new to the students for the gearbox design. Sometimes we have to stop here. So just arranging the kinematic arrangement is enough. But in some cases they have to design the gear also. It is very rare. But in the university examination, you have to draw up to the kinematic arrangement. So select the suitable material for the gear, then you have to follow the procedure for the designing the gear. Calculate the torque to be transmitted for the each shaft, determine minimum center distance between the shaft, taking the worst working condition, that is low RPM, high output. Determine module for the worst working condition. Use the same module, determine the actual number of teeth for all the gears between the adjacent shaft. The sum of the teeth engaging pair should be equal. So the when you have two gears engaging in parallel shaft, the number of teeth should be equal. Then only we can have same radial distance. Then design the shaft and fix the casing dimensions. So these are all the steps for designing the gearbox, multiple speed gearbox. So it is very easy when you understand the concept. So there are three diagrams you have to draw: structural diagram, ray diagram, and kinematic arrangement. So with that we can limit. With that this is enough for the undergraduate student for solving the problem. So when you want to design the gear completely, then we have to design the gear and calculate all the power transmission between the shaft. So normally in the university examination, we will be drawing the structural diagram, ray diagram, and then the kinematic arrangement. So in the kinematic arrangement, we will be mentioning number of teeth on each gear for the given output speed. So I stop here. So these are all the books I publish in the mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. And in the next lecture, we will solve problem in the gearbox design. I will give minimum two examples for 6-speed, 9-speed, 12-speed and 18-speed gearbox. And I take a problem only from the university question paper so that you will get the confident of solving problem in the university examination. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me to my mail ID for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in the next video with a problem on the gearbox design. Until then, bye.